is going. If you are in the path of this storm, this is a very strong thunderstorm with possible rotation. You want to take cover immediately. Treat this as if it is a tornado warning. It'll be in Sky Valley at 11:50. That's basically right now. So the leading edge of this is in Sky Valley. Some of the stronger winds just behind that, about 3-4 minutes away. Also in Franklin at 12:17, and in Bryson City at 1:05. We have a another warning that's for somewhere else. So we're looking at a possibility of rotation here. Let's take a look. Let's get inside this storm now that we've kind of put a track on it and take a look. Some possible weak level rotation. I'm not seeing anything, too powerful right now. That, of course, could change, which is why we track these and we wait for these live scans to kind of rotate and give us live information, live feedback as it's happening. But let's zoom out for you just a minute, because there's lots of heavy rainfall all around this storm. We've got the outer bands of a very strong system that continues to move in and out of the area. That's bringing some heavy rainfall. And I tell you, some of these systems, folks, are very rain wrapped. So it's very tough to see outside of these. So it's one of those that if you're, running outside and you want to try to see this, please don't. It's not the best idea, because these systems, we've got so much rainfall right now that it's just tough to see anything. But if you are in the path of this storm, let's zoom in. Let's try to get a little bit closer to some of these street levels. Tallulah Falls, your area, Highway 23, where it intersects with 76. Once again, we're kind of meeting up against lunchtime, where a lot of folks want to maybe head out and get some lunch. Stay put. If you live in this area, this is not a good time to do that. Let me zoom out a little bit more. This is heading to the north toward Franklin, west of Cashers, west of Clemson. Clemson's getting some heavy rainfall right now. But again, the strongest winds and the heaviest amount of rain is right here in Clayton and Turnsville. Again, a tornado warning in effect until 12:45 today, 12:30. Excuse me, 12:30. This did have some radar indicated tornado, some possible strong rotation. So we continue to track this as it continues to push to the north. In fact, we are looking at this moving to the north. These systems are moving through pretty quickly, by the way. This one's not moving as fast. This one's moving to the north at 15 miles per hour. So let's zoom out in case you're just now joining us and put another storm track on this. Here you go, moving to the north. This will be in Watkins Mill in about 3 minutes. This will be in Franklin at 12:17, Cowie at 12:36, and then on to Greens Creek. Again, if you are in the path of this storm, take cover immediately. If we are talking to kids who are having school at home today, we've been saying this all morning long. If you're just now joining us, kids, and you're not sure what to do, if you're upstairs, go downstairs, get into the lowest floor or the lowest level of your home. Get away from a room that has a lot of windows, probably like a living room or dining room, right? You probably want to go for the bathroom if you're unsure where to go. If an adult hasn't told you, then find a room downstairs, probably a bathroom, and just hang out there for the next few minutes until this storm passes, okay? It is a tornado warning that remains in effect for the next several minutes. Possible rotation. We'll take a look at some of the winds in and around this. Again, possibly some upper level rotation with this one. Not seeing anything at ground level potentially just yet. That doesn't mean that that will not change. We've got a lot of tools here that give us the ability to kind of look inside some of these storms. This one also, by the way, does not have a lot of lightning with it, which is good. We are seeing some lightning, but it's more about the rain and the wind and the possibility of rotation. This has been a very active area. If you've been following us for any time this morning, we've been following, Toccoa, Elberton, now Wahala and Franklin. Beginning to see some of these thunderstorms just fire up. These are part of the outer bands of the remnants of Fred. So we're beginning to see some of these kind of these pieces of energy kind of whip around and move across the area. And to the south of all of this is the remnants of the core. That is where the strongest winds are. And that is where we will see the greatest risk, believe it or not, for even more severe weather. So that will carry over into the next few hours, meaning the early hours of the afternoon, possibly through the time that a lot of you will be going to pick up your kids from school. I will say the one thing we have working in our favor here is this system is moving very quickly. In fact, the remnants, the core, beginning to push through Atlanta right now. So we're on the east side. We're getting kind of the heaviest amount of rain right now. We're getting some of those outer bands, some of the most severe part of this, but the strongest winds remain just to the south. So again, we're getting some of the severe weather now, but I do anticipate this to continue for the next couple of hours at least. So as we zoom in a little bit closer, Wahala, boy, you know already, you get a lot of rainfall. You're one of kind of those hot spots where the rain is drawn to. You're getting a ton of rain. You got some rainfall yesterday. You've gotten a ton this morning, and now you've got a tornado warning that remains in effect here for the next several minutes. So we continue to track this as this moves to the north at about 15 miles per hour. I'm joined now with meteorologist Sydney Sullivan. Sydney, what are you seeing right now?
Yeah, just what you were saying. You know, we are continuing to monitor this. Oconee County, you are right in the path. Clayton, Tallulah Falls area as well. As of right now, it looks like as far as rotation goes, I'm not really seeing any strong rotation at this point. Looking for any lofted debris. Could see some indications near Clayton at this point. So what lofted debris is indicating, this is not technically rain. This is anything that might be in the air other than rain. Could potentially see that right near Clayton. So if you are really in Clayton, Tallulah Falls, stretching right towards the border here, this is where things look to be the most active as it does continue working its way primarily towards the north. We'll put a track on here. At this point, we'll do it towards this area where you can see this, the reds. This is really some heavy rain as well. So Battle Creek, Camp Creek Church, Wolf Creek Church, New Hope Church. If you are in the line of this possibly tornado, you definitely need to get to the lowest level of your home. Put as many many walls between you and the outside. Take cover, get to the lowest level of your home, your building, wherever you might be at this point. So still seeing heavy amounts of rain, still pushing through Tallulah Falls, Clayton, right near the border, and heads up towards Franklin. You will likely get in on some of this action as well. I do expect some of this to weaken at least briefly, but again, these storms are very fast moving. So that is good news. It gets out of our area pretty quickly, but it does mean we still have that potential for strong to severe storms, as well as even a few spin up tornadoes throughout the rest of the afternoon and even getting us into the evening. So we're still continuing to monitor this. Not seeing any new reports, at least as of right now. Flash flood warning still in place for really our entire area as this does continue to drop heavy amounts of rain. And of course, wind is still going to be a concern with some of these outer bands moving in from Fred. So that's what we're looking at right now as we continue to monitor this. Perella, yeah. Are you seeing anything?
You know, I tell you, it's been interesting because, you know, we were talking about earlier this morning, it's going to be, you know, mid-morning through the afternoon is kind of that hot spot, that sweet spot. And boy, starting around 10 o'clock, Sydney and I have been tracking these tornado warnings basically for the past several hours. The hot spots definitely have been, you know, Toccoa, Elberton areas, basically Tallulah Falls, where we're seeing this right now, and Clayton. These have been the areas that have kind of been a bit more primed, if you will. These are the first areas that had the tornado watch at 4 o'clock this morning. Those will expire here in about another hour, and then those tornado watches kind of take over for the rest of our viewing area until tonight. But yeah, these are very strong storm, folks. And again, a lot of these we have seen rotation. Now, what's likely happening is we're seeing some very quick spin-ups because we're seeing rotation with these, and then they kind of die out or dissipate, and then they kind of pop back up. That's very common. That can happen, especially when you have winds whipping out of these outer bands from the remnants of these storms, like what we have been seeing. And again, we've still got a couple more hours where we anticipate following storms just like this. So we'll go ahead and put another track on this. This one's moving to the north at about 30 miles per hour. And yes, we'll continue to see this kind of produce some heavy amounts of rain as we go throughout, oh, the next several hours at least. In fact, we're looking at some heavy rain, a little bit of lightning embedded in these. And then, yes, we are looking at the possibility of some rotation as well. Okay. All right. Looking like this is dying out a little bit to me, Sydney. I don't think this is really holding together too well. I do think that if you were in the path of this storm, go ahead and treat it like this is a tornado on the ground. Always, always when you have a tornado warning. A warning means that it's imminent or it's already happening. In other words, it's just a second away. It's just, you know, it's got all the ingredients. It could happen at any moment, or it's already on the ground. So this tornado warning is still active. Might not be in the next couple of minutes here, but we want to make sure that we stay with you and keep you updated until this does officially end. If you're along Highway 23, if you are along Highway 76, this is definitely where you know, the heaviest amount of rain is. The National Weather Service has decided to allow this tornado warning to expire, but we will likely see a few more of these as we go throughout the next several hours. So at the moment, just looking at some very heavy rainfall, again, in an area where we have a tornado watch. All right, so that's it for now. I know our noon show starts here any second now, so I'm going to turn it back over to our regularly scheduled program, and I'll be back with you here in probably a minute or less. Stay tuned.
Live, local, breaking news. This is WYFF News 4 at noon.
Now, in the event of a tornado warning issued for your location, you are asked to seek safety immediately. We are getting to that breaking news right now, actually. We're going to go ahead and toss it straight over to Perella Lewis, who's got the latest for us this afternoon. Perella.
All right, Destiny, thank you so much. I just restarted this computer here. There we go. Just took a second. Okay, a tornado watch is in effect for most of our viewing area. This is in effect for basically until 7 o'clock tonight, okay? So this hasn't changed a lot. We are going to keep this in effect. In fact, for Toccoa, Hartwell, and Elberton, this will end for you at 1 o'clock. But you see, for the rest of our viewing area, this will be in effect until 7 o'clock tonight. Again, that's a tornado watch. On top of that, we have a flash flood watch in effect for basically all of our viewing area until tomorrow morning. So that right there shows you our biggest concern for the day. It is, of course, the rain, and it is the possibility of tornadoes. We've already had several tornado warnings throughout this morning. Here's what's going on. Here's kind of the big picture. We've got the remnants of Fred just to the south of Atlanta. So some of these outer bands, some of these stronger winds, and some of these heavier downpours just on the outskirts of that. That's what's coming through our area right now, and really has been moving through the area the past couple of hours. But the strongest winds still yet to come, the biggest lift in the atmosphere that will further destabilize things and continue our risk for severe weather, well, that's going to carry over into the afternoon hours, unfortunately. Right now, some heavy rainfall across Franklin, Wahala, Clemson, Anderson, back into Abbeville. You see a little bit of a break, a little bit of a hole right now in Toccoa and Hartwell, where you've had quite a bit of rainfall, but we've got another wave coming your way. So unfortunately, we are not done just yet. Now, the western half of our viewing area has definitely been the favored spot so far, but that's going to spread a little bit more as we go into the next few hours, again, as that core moves overhead. By the way, we've got a moderate or medium risk for severe weather for our entire viewing area, and again, this is just going to ramp up as we get into the afternoon. Our main concern continues to be flooding, some very strong thunderstorms, which you've already seen, and yes, the possibility of more tornadoes is definitely likely. As we go throughout the afternoon, it's going to continue. So as you're going to pick your kids up from school, you're likely going to need to stay weather aware as you're heading home. And even after you get home and you're having dinner, some of this will still be around across the upstate and most certainly in the mountains as well. We'll take a more detailed look at this and the latest on the tropics as well. I'll have the latest on that coming up in just a few minutes.
All right, Perella, thank you. Well, some people may have felt an earthquake this morning. A 2.7 magnitude earthquake was reported in Morganton, North Carolina, which is in Burke County. The quake was reported around 9:20. At last check, no damages or injuries have been reported. The statewide battle over mask mandates continues as kids, faculty, and staff head back to school. The state superintendent of education is teaming up with pediatricians to make herself heard. And our Patrick Hushen is here in studio with the latest. Patrick.
Destiny, in the upstate classrooms, in the upstate, The classrooms for Abbeville, Anderson, Lawrence, and Greenville counties all opened up today. But also today, there was a press conference, and State Superintendent Molly Spearman, DHEC State Epidemiologist Dr. Linda Bell, and the state's chapter of the American Academy of Pediatrics say that keeping South Carolina schools open for the entirety of the school year is crucial to student success. But they all agree everyone should be masked, especially students too young to be vaccinated.
I am certain that when history is written, people will look back in wonder at how we were nearing normalcy, then had a dramatic resurgence in this disease, given all the tools we had available to prevent what is unfolding right now.
Folks, we're better than this. We're smarter than this. Parents, please listen to your doctors. Let's not go by what we read on social media.
Okay, now this is Governor Henry McMaster and Attorney General Alan Wilson. Both say that mask mandates in the schools in South Carolina are a violation of state law. Now, just this week, just yesterday, two of the largest school districts in the state, Charleston and Richland counties, voted to approve an emergency ordinance to require masks for anyone who enters school buildings. And that puts both districts at risk of losing state funding, according to state law. Meanwhile, South Carolina's largest school district, Greenville County, holds steady in accordance with the law. We're going to have more on today's press conference later here on WYFF News 4. Destiny.
All right, Patrick, thank you. It's back to the classroom for students in Greenville County. Our Daniel Robinson joins us live from the New Fountain Inn High School. And Daniel, what are you hearing from some of the students out there?
And Destiny, many students say they are excited to be back. And earlier today, around 350 freshmen were welcomed back here, not only by faculty and staff, but get this, by a robot as well. Now, those students will be the very first class to walk through these doors. A warm and futuristic welcome.
Hey, you got it, you got it.
To a new beginning.
A little nervous, but I'm kind of excited. It's a good facility, it's got food. Kind of excited for the food.
It's not only Julian Watson's first day in high school, but as a student in the state.
We went to the beach for a few weeks, and that was really fun.
Oh, really excited, and this facility is so beautiful inside, and seeing everything that they had to offer, the fact that he'll only be the ninth graders here really makes us excited about the fact that he gets to try it out first.
Watson's family recently moved from Colorado, and the new state-of-the-art high school was one of the reasons they settled on Fountain Inn.
Probably like mechatronics and like the use of like power tools and stuff like that. Like, you get more freedom.
Aubrey Meltzer also looking forward to the school year.
I think I'm very happy to be back. I definitely understand the concern of other people wanting to stay home, but for me personally, it is better to come back in person, especially with we're starting block schedule. I think it'll be much easier for me to be in person with the teacher and be able to learn quicker, just in an environment.
Meltzer says with the added COVID-19 safety precautions, such as extra cleaning and hand sanitizer stations, she has no problem returning.
I feel safe. If I feel the need to wear a mask, I will put one on. I have masks with me at all times, so I feel safe. But if I'm going to evaluate the area and if I need to put one on, then I will.
A feeling echoed by one parent.
Well, I feel like he's going to be in good shape, and we spent the summer being socially distanced and feel like they've taken the right precautions here, so it'll be that shouldn't be an issue.
As students navigate high school and changes because of COVID-19, Seth Watson is sending words of encouragement.
I'm proud of you. Be kind and enjoy. This is a great 4 years to start.
And in terms of wearing a face mask in the classroom, we just heard Patrick mention a little bit about this, but here in Greenville County, they're leaving that decision up to the students and the parents right now with no mask mandate in place, but it is still a recommendation from the CDC and DHEC. For now, live in Fountain Inn, Dana Robinson, WYFF News 4.
All right, Daniel, thank you for that. Hundreds of South Carolina students are already quarantined for COVID-19. This has prompted the state's second largest school district to require masks in schools. In spite of that state budget proviso that would take school funding if a district mandates masks. Charleston County School District's board and the Richland County Council both voted last night to approve an emergency ordinance to require the face coverings in schools and daycares. The vote follows a similar measure in Columbia. State Attorney General Alan Wilson has already said the Columbia mandate is against state law. Now to the latest coronavirus numbers in South Carolina. DHEC is reporting more than 2,500 new confirmed cases of COVID. More than 14% of the tests reported Monday were positive. In North Carolina, health officials are reporting more than 3,000 new cases of COVID. And in Georgia, health officials are reporting more than 14,000 new cases of COVID, pushing the state's total closer to 1 million. Georgia's death toll is more than 19,000. In Greenville County, South Carolina, Highway Patrol says one person was killed in a crash on Frontage Road about 3 miles south of Greenville. This happened just before 2 this morning. The vehicle drove off the left side of the road, hit a fence and a tree. Troopers say the driver was not wearing a seatbelt and died at the hospital. We do have breaking news this afternoon in Spartanburg County. The woman charged in connection with a wrong-way crash that killed 3 teenagers just made a court appearance. Bond was denied for Melissa Parker. The crash happened just after 2 a.m. Monday on I-26 near Highway 176. Troopers say Parker was driving a Hummer in the wrong direction and crashed into a sedan. Troopers say 4 teenagers were inside that car. Twins, 17-year-old Elena and Isabella Gaddis, and 18-year-old Brianna Foster all died at the scene. The coroner says the 3 girls were from Fishers, Indiana. A 4th teen was taken to the hospital. The twins' family spoke during the bond hearing.
We packed the trunk. They were the brightest, most loving, perfect, like the joys of light. Like their whole life was about lifting other people up. I came home to my house last night and there was a half a dozen girls waiting to hug me for them. You know what I mean? Like to show their love.
Wow. Troopers say Parker ran from the scene but was shortly arrested after. Parker is charged with multiple counts of felony hit and run with death and DUI with death. She is being held in the Spartanburg County Detention Center. Coming up, the latest from the Middle East as the Taliban continues to take over Afghanistan.
All right, our entire viewing area continues under a tornado watch until 7 o'clock tonight with some thunderstorms, some very strong storms moving in right now and more to come. We'll time it out and get you caught up on the very latest when we come back.
WYFF News 4 Today is right here with you.
We're staying on top of changing COVID guidelines in our school districts.
Answering questions and sharing the excitement of getting your kids back to school.
WYFF News 4 Today.
Did you know that 178 million Americans are missing at least one tooth?
It's true.
That's why at Affordable Dentures and Implants, we only focus on tooth replacement solutions.
Whether it's a single tooth, full dentures, or dental implants, we have an experienced dentist who can create a new smile just for you.
At a price that's affordable.
Because at Affordable Dentures and Implants, we want you to go ahead and smile.
And RJ Construction have been the trusted name in roofing for more than 15 years. It's speculated that material prices will double by the end of the year, so don't wait to get a new roof. With RJ Construction, you can lock in today's pricing. This month only, get free money with 0% financing for 5 years. This offer ends soon. Call now for a free estimate and get 0% financing for 5 years. If your home needs a new roof, Clifford knows who's best.
RJ Construction.
Wave goodbye to your drafty house and say hello to comfort.
Anna here for Windworld with Tucker and my rescue cat Max. Here at home and here at Windworld, we're into comfort and conserving energy. Come see me at the showroom and let us show you how to save money on your utility bills.
Right now, get 10 windows or 6 windows and a patio door for just $125 per month installed. That's professionally installed and backed by our lifetime limited warranty.
Say goodbye to high prices and hello to comfort. Windworld, simply the best for less.
WYFF News 4, live local breaking news.
Welcome back. Military flights evacuating people from Afghanistan have resumed. This comes as people are desperate to flee following the Taliban's takeover of the country. NBC's Richard Engel reports from Kabul.
Kabul Airport this morning is back up and running. Evacuation flights in full swing. Flights were stopped yesterday when tens of thousands of Afghans stormed onto the runways, desperate to leave. Some Afghans were able to get out. On one flight so full, it may have set a record for the number of people who can fit onto an American C-17. Afghans are running from the Taliban, now in full control. Today, the Taliban told Afghans they have nothing to fear. The group called on civil servants to return to work, offered a non-specific general amnesty, and called on women to join their new government. But the Taliban also said they will always be guided by strict Islamic Sharia law. Many Afghans don't believe the Taliban's promises of tolerance.
Somebody should help me.
Haseeb, a translator for the U.S. military, is one of thousands in hiding this morning. Translators have been marked for death by the Taliban. Haseeb has no visa to the U.S. and no way of getting to the airport if he had one. We're not showing his face for his safety.
Right now I am in Kabul, and Kabul is surrounded by the Taliban. I'm not safe here. This is all the documents to prove that I was an interpreter.
The Taliban are trying to show they're an open, legitimate government ready to engage with the world. Now they have to prove it to a skeptical and frightened nation. The Taliban have even offered to work with members of the former government they just overthrew. The question is, can they be trusted? Richard Engel, NBC News, Kabul.
Health facilities are overwhelmed following an earthquake that struck Haiti over the weekend. The death toll from the earthquake has risen to more than 1,400, and around 6,000 people were injured. Doctors said they're running short of painkillers and steel pins for fractures. Officials said more than 7,000 homes were destroyed and nearly 5,000 damaged from the quake. Around 30,000 families have been left homeless.
All right, good afternoon. It is 12:15, and we continue to follow these tornado watches that are in effect for our entire viewing area until 7 o'clock tonight. The 1 o'clock this afternoon is for Elberton, Hartwell, and Toccoa, but the National Weather Service has included basically our entire viewing area until 7 o'clock tonight. We also have a flash flood watch also for our entire viewing area until tomorrow morning. So you can see right there the main concerns are the flooding and, of course, the severe thunderstorms and possible tornadoes. We've already had several tornado warnings posted right here along this first leg, if you will, of these outer bands. We've had several outer bands kind of come in waves all morning, but this has been the strongest so far. And guess what? To the south of this is going to be even stronger because the remnants of this storm is just to the south, or the core of it is just to the south, kind of pushing north through Atlanta right now. We're on the east side, so we've got the strongest winds and the most impacts still heading our way later today. In fact, as we take a look, Tropical Depression Fred still organized enough to spin up some brief tornadoes as we go into the next few hours, moving overhead over our area, specifically early this afternoon, and then we'll continue to see it lift throughout the afternoon and evening time frame. Let's quickly get you caught up on other things going on in the tropics. We've got Tropical Storm Grace expected now to strengthen to a Category 1 hurricane by tomorrow as it passes over the Yucatan Peninsula. It weakens, it re-strengthens again before making landfall, potentially as a Category 1 storm in Mexico this weekend. We've got Tropical Storm Henri. This one's just kind of circling around Bermuda, expected to kind of move out to sea, become what we call a fish storm, meaning it is not expected to impact land, which is good news. It is really all about Fred right now. As we continue to track the remnants, again, those outer bands, we've had a lot of rainfall move through since early this morning, and we're going to get some more. What's going to happen is as the core pushes through, this is going to provide a further lift or a destabilization across the atmosphere, and that's going to shake things up all over again. So our moderate risk for severe weather, this has been trimmed back a little bit to no longer include Elberton and Hartwell under that moderate risk. You know why? Because your part is over. The worst of it has already passed. You will still see some rainfall. You will still see some thunderstorm, and there's still a low in risk that you might still see some rotation, but overall, that risk includes just about everyone else as we go into the next several hours. This extends all the way into Virginia today. The main concern, of course, flooding. We're looking at landslides in the mountains. We're looking at downed trees because our soils are so saturated, and you get underneath one of these thunderstorms with some of these strong winds, and then you have downed trees, or even worse, you get some rotation, you get a tornado, and yes, there is a moderate risk for that as well as we go throughout the next several hours. So these are our main concerns for today. Yes, there'll be lightning, but it won't be electric. electrical storms. As we take a look at the timing, here's 2-3 o'clock today, just as some of you will be heading out to pick up your kids. Yes, there will be some thunderstorms around the area. Yes, we could have potentially severe weather at that time. Then as you're heading home from work, say 5, 5:30, 6 o'clock, most of the heaviest rain should have lifted to the north. It's going to be pushing into the mountains where you really don't need much more rain, especially from Cullowhee on west. But unfortunately, that's what you're going to get. But we're still going to have still some scattered showers around and some thunderstorms to be talking about potentially 7, 8, 9 o'clock tonight. And then this wraps around. It shrinks. It moves faster. And by late tonight, this is out of here. Maybe a few leftover showers early tomorrow, but I'm really not seeing much chance of that at all. Then we just kind of return to our regularly scheduled summertime pattern by Thursday. So how much rainfall will we be looking at? Well, from 12:19, from this moment until tomorrow morning. So really this moment until about midnight tonight, an additional 1-2 inches of rain, 3, possibly 4 in isolated areas in the mountains. If you get underneath a thunderstorm or underneath a tornado warning, then obviously you will be getting more, a lot of rain in a short amount of time. It is an alert day. This is why. Heading into tomorrow, it's going to be mid-80s, a few spotty showers early on, but I really anticipate most of tomorrow being dry. Thursday, Friday, Saturday, just a few pop-up thunderstorms as we kind of get back to where we left off, just not quite as hot or quite as humid. Destiny?
Perla, thank you for that update. Well, still to come, the rising costs for back-to-school shopping, how parents are dealing with the increase.
The Sky Cam Network is sponsored by McKinney Jeep Ram Chrysler Dodge, your lifetime dealer.
Save on new Rams and Jeeps during the Make This the Summer event at McKinney Jeep Ram Chrysler Dodge.
That's why McKinney is your lifetime dealer.
You're in a hurry. Download the WYFF4 app and get local news, weather, and video fast. Get your news fix. Get the app.
I would give him 15 out of 10 stars. You'll always be super satisfied with Preferred.
On time and friendly.
Very pleased with Preferred. Would highly recommend. Prompt service. Technician was skilled, polite, and efficient with our plumbing issues.
5 stars, thumbs up. We absolutely recommend Preferred Home Services.
These guys rock their jobs and are consummate professionals.
Thanks for calling Preferred. How can we make you smile today?
Do you suffer daily with pain, numbness, tingling, or burning in your feet or hands that never seems to go away? Your doctor may have diagnosed you with peripheral neuropathy or possibly carpal tunnel syndrome and has you taking drugs such as Lyrica or Neurontin, also called gabapentin, that never seems to fix your neuropathy. Your balance may also be affected because long-standing peripheral neuropathy causes a disconnect between the nerves of your feet and your brain. These debilitating balance problems may eventually end you up in a walker or wheelchair if left untreated. There is now a facility that can help to reverse your neuropathy. Call to schedule your neuropathy severity exam today with our highly skilled medical team to see if our treatment methods are right for you. As long as you haven't reached 85% sensory loss, then our treatment methods may work for you. We accept most major health insurances, including Medicare. Call right now to schedule or online at vitalitymedcenters.com.
Welcome back, and we are taking a look at stocks this afternoon. Everything is down. The Dow down more than 352 points. NASDAQ down more than 185 points. S&P 500 down more than 43 points. The Atlanta Falcons now is the first NFL franchise to be fully vaccinated against COVID-19. The team says players can now forego daily tests, mask wearing, and quarantines following close contact with people who test positive. As of Saturday, all 32 of the league's team had topped vaccination rates of 75%, with 15 teams above 95%. The upcoming Tokyo Paralympics will follow the lead of the Olympic Games and ban fans from attending events. Organizers are also asking the public to not attend the road events. New infections in Tokyo tripled during the 17 days of the Olympics, with about 11,000 athletes in attendance. Medical experts say the surge was not directly linked to the Tokyo Games. The Paralympics open on August 24th, with nearly 4,500 athletes expected to compete. One in three parents of school-age children expect to go into debt when shopping for back to school. According to a new survey from LendingTree, nearly a third of parents say they're unable to afford their child's school supplies this year. As school supplies expenses increase and hybrid learning costs more than either in-person only learning or virtual only school. Well, same-day delivering service Shipt surveyed 1,000 teachers to find out exactly what students are in need of, and more than half said that pencils will be the number one item to restock. Hand sanitizer and tissues were also high on the list for the school year. The top two traditional school supplies that should be crossed off the list are books and book covers. The teacher suggests going with an e-reader instead. Stay with us. We will be right back with one more check on weather.
Marcia has sleep apnea, and her struggles with CPAP had me sleeping in the guest room. Now she's got Inspire.
No mask, no hose, just sleep.
Now I'm back.
And we're back.
Inspire. Learn more at inspiresleep.com.
Louie, this customer needs an easy access shower.
Yes, Jack, a lot of our customers have a hard time stepping into the tub. This easy